Hey, BP, how you doing? I'm JB Bauer.
You got it wrong. You messed up. It's JB Campbell Bauer.
Yay!
You don't look so scary in person, Mr. James.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did I let you down?
I used to play in a band as well when I was 15. So we used to play there, and that club night didn't even start till 11:30, which, you know, 16, 15, you know, you go, crikey, you know, 11:30, that's so late. Actually, I say that more now as well. I'm normally in bed by 9 o'clock, to be fair. Yeah.
Like, I am a vampire, and that's not how it is. I'm like, okay, dude.
She is Nosferatu. Thank you so much.
The ones that are most the fun to write are Magnus and Jace, because they always have something sassy to say.
Or nothing to wear.
Or nothing. In Magnus's case,
yeah, exactly.
Nothing to wear.
And
I saw Godfrey on Saturday, and he would like to share an important fact with you all, which is that the underwear that he was wearing, that the pants he was wearing in the scene, at Magnus's party are his own.
Also, he wanted me to tell you all that it was really cold when we were shooting. Don't know what that means. Take from that what
no
you
No judgment, very cold.
I don't know.
And you look like a film star. I mean, like a proper one.
No, I think I look like a footballer a little bit.
Oh, do you?
No.
There's a guy calling me Robbie Savage. I don't know what.
Oh, that does not seem.
I know, but it's a lovely grey suit.
Yeah.
I feel a little bit like, I don't know. Footballer.
I got to kick a lot of ass. That was kind of cool.
It was so riveting. I walked in and my heart was beating from start to finish.
Yay.
Happy days.
That's good, because then you would have been dead if it had stopped.
It says, what type of movie is it?
Porn.
Young adult porn?
Just porn.
Yap.
Yap.
But if I was to take you for a night out, it would probably be dinner. Dinner and a show, maybe. I love dancing. I'm a bit of a dancer. I actually ended up dancing with somebody's mum in a tiny little country pub the other day.
All three of you have such huge fan bases and have such influence over sort of hundreds and thousands of people's lives. And I was just wondering, if you could do anything with that influence, what would you do?
Oh God. You go first.
You!
You don't want to know. Hey, it's your imagination.
And I love that you guys say this was very much a bonding film because you're around, you know, one another all the time. Kevin Seegers, who we love, he was on the show
love
recently.
Love Kevin.
Right? Oh,
did you enjoy getting in shape for the role, other than not being able to eat cookies?
I went and did 4 months of training before we started shooting. 4 months of physical training. I was out of shape, but I wasn't in shape, that's for sure. And I wanted, you know, look at the book. The front cover of a book is a guy with his torso out and his muscles out, so I have to try and stick somewhat similar to that.
The humor and the kind of lifestyle in Dublin, I mean, Robbie is very much representative of what I... No, it's great. It's great. I didn't...
The stereotypical
Irish
man is what
he wanders around with a shillelagh and...
No, he's dancing as well.
No, he's dancing.
Jamie, you're no stranger to the young adult film genre.
Yeah, I'm into my sequels. Yeah. I'm into my franchises,
yeah,
one could
that's
say.
What I'll think about franchises.
Yeah. No, I'm into my franchises. You know, I joked with someone last week that I'm a franchise whore. I truly believe that.
So I was wondering if there were any franchises out there right now that you'd like to conquer next after this one.
Hmm. Oh, that's a very, very loaded question, isn't it?
So what casting directors do you need?
Exactly. Hubbard, if you're listening.
Sexiest co-star I've ever had is Ian McKellen. The man is a sexy Gandalf. That's what I want to be when I grow up.
If I could make a cake of rainbows and promises and
and unicorns.
Rainbows and promises.
That's right. You couldn't have any.
I like that. I can't have any. What? Rubbish.
The book signing, right?
Yes, exactly. Two writers live on the way to one of the mangoes. What a Canada, actually.
Oh, amazing.
Quite kidding.
Amazing. Well, I hope the mangoes, they were plastic mangoes,
yes,
were they? Okay, good, because I was going to say, like, it's better than a plastic one than a real one.
Yeah, exactly.
Terrible. She's awful. She's a terrible girl. No, she's lovely.
I'm ready?
Wait. You're recording.
I'm so fine.
Delicious meal.
Delicious meal. Delicious meal.
Do you believe in magic?
I do believe in magic. I mean, not like David Blaine. He's obviously not magic, but like, you know.
There's
I believe in supernatural.
Yeah.
I think because it's a larger body of people, your chances of success are somewhat limited.
Ah,
I don't know. But it's wonderful.
I like that kind of the actor thing as well. It's very nice.
Yeah.
Hey, listen. You have two.
I think the biggest misconception about Londoners is that we all hate each other, or that we all hate everybody else. Like nobody talks to each other on the tube. My favourite game was to try and get everyone to start talking to each other, or freak people out as much as possible and then get people laughing. It's just breaking down that barrier, first of all. It's not that we all hate each other, it's just that we're all afraid to talk to each other because we think we all hate each other. It's sort of a self-fulfilling prophecy. It doesn't really make any sense to me. We're just all very confused. And we just want to be loved, really. That's what we want. All Londoners want to be loved. All of us.
I am getting a Mortal Instruments tattoo. Yay! I didn't know what, and then I decided on a quote, and then I sort of went to Love Is to Destroy, and then I was like, To Love Is to Destroy is pretty dark. Like, it's not like the nicest thing you want to be seeing on somebody. It's going on my back, and it's a quote, and it is. I don't want to tell you anymore. It is, I am, after all, what you made me.
Oh. Very nice.
Now you're committed.
I am committed.
It's true.
It's not like on the lower back, it's not like a tramp stamp. I just want to make that plainly clear to everybody. Before, like, TMZ, like, snap
picks
me.
Up on that.
Yeah,
then.
Exactly.
I was like, look, I need to work, I need something that's going to, keep me going over, because right now I'm basically probably on the streets, in a couple of months' time. So I needed something that would tie me over. King Arthur came along, and I was like, yeah, fuck it, whatever. I'll take that. I'll play a historical figure and try my best. Peace yourself.
We will have to wait and see.
Okay, we'll have a lovely evening. Thank you so much.
Bye bye. Bye bye. Oh.